Hello guys, welcome back to Watch Time! Today's movie recap will be a horror and adventure movie from 1986 called The Golden Child. Warning, there are spoilers ahead. The movie begins in 1986 in Tibet, where we see monks in a temple meditating and chanting. A young boy enjoys a puppet show and appears to be special, as the monks take extra care of him and treat him like royalty. Meanwhile, invaders are heading towards the temple, and we see that guards outside have already been attacked. Inside, a monk presents the boy with a tray of dead birds. The boy touches one, and it miraculously comes back to life, amazing the monks. Suddenly, the invaders storm the temple, attacking the monks violently. The boy is captured and placed in a cage to be transported. One invader trips and falls, and their leader warns him not to touch the boy. However, the boy quickly touches him, causing him to turn against their leader. The leader teleports away to escape. It seems the boy influenced the invader's mind to attack his own leader, but the controlled invader is soon overpowered by his comrades. Elsewhere in a vibrant city, we meet Chandler Gerald, who is busy posting pictures of missing children. He later appears on a TV show to discuss a missing girl he's looking for. The host, however, seeks a more sensational story and ignores the plight of the missing child. Frustrated, Chandler grabs the microphone, announces the missing girl's situation, and storms off the show. In the next scene, Chandler is playing basketball with some kids when a woman watching them catches the ball. As Chandler retrieves it, she mentions seeing him on TV and talks about a missing child in Tibet. Chandler responds that Tibet is outside his area of work. The woman insists the boy is special and destined to save the world, claiming Chandler is the chosen one to rescue him from his kidnappers. Skeptical, Chandler mocks her beliefs and suggests she needs psychiatric help. In another scene, the missing girl's body is located, and Chandler, along with a detective, investigates the area. While there, he spots the woman from earlier watching him and notices a cup filled with blood and oat. After leaving the crime scene, Chandler does more investigating and realizes the woman he jokingly calls Miss Tibet is still following him. He approaches her and they talk, and she explains that the same people who killed the missing girl kidnapped the special boy in Tibet. She suggests consulting someone who can explain the significance of the blood he saw in the crime scene. They visit a mysterious woman called Kala, hidden behind a veil, who warns that if the boy's life ends, the world will face catastrophe. She reveals that although the special boy is usually invulnerable, he could be harmed if he ingests blood. Later that evening, as Miss Tibet drives Chandler home, he invites her up, but she chooses to stay in the car. The scene shifts to where the special boy is being held captive, surrounded by evil monks who chant quietly to suppress his powers. A man starts playing with the boy, and the boy amusingly turns a Pepsi can into a dancing puppet, delighting the man. However, the leader of the kidnappers abruptly enters and orders the man to leave. He then tries to weaken the boy by offering him food with hidden blood, but the boy dumps the food away and secretly eats a leaf he hides in his pocket, which helps him regain some power. The surrounding monks fall asleep, allowing the boy to send a message to Chandler through a vision in his window. Chandler sees the boy and the bird he had revived earlier. Suddenly, Chandler receives a phone call about some bikers who kidnapped the girl. The next morning, Chandler and Miss Tibet visit the biker's house. Chandler is captured and tied up, but Miss Tibet rescues him by cutting the ropes binding his hands, and he manages to fight off the bikers. Chandler then interrogates one of the bikers about the missing girl. The biker reveals that they kidnapped her to sell to a man named Tommy Tong, who needed the girl's blood for a deal with the devil. They then went to confront Tommy at his place. Chandler left Miss Tibet in the car and entered to inquire about Tommy. However, no one there spoke English, making communication difficult. Tommy realized he was being sought and attacked Chandler. Miss Tibet intervened, scaring Tommy away with her combat skills, but they couldn't catch him. While Tommy is hiding, the leader of the kidnappers, who could transform from a rat into a man, appeared and killed Tommy, then transformed back into a rat and left. Chandler and Miss Tibet arrived to find Tommy's lifeless body. The leader of the kidnappers teleported back to the prison where the special boy was held and contacted the devil to update him on the situation. The devil informed him that the boy wouldn't eat the food they had provided and instructed the leader to find a dagger capable of killing the child, as the chosen one was drawing near. Back at Chandler's home, he was sleeping, but suddenly woke up in an unfamiliar room. As he explored, he encountered the leader of the kidnappers, unaware of who he was, thinking it was all a dream. An audience was present, laughing and clapping at Chandler's jokes. The leader attempted to make Chandler an offer and warned him about his joking demeanor. Chandler, still believing it was a dream, dismissed the reality of the situation. The leader then proposed a trade, the special boy for the Ajanti dagger. To prove the reality of their encounter, one of the leader's henchmen burned Chandler's hand. When Chandler woke up, he discovered the burn was real. They quickly visited the mysterious veiled woman named Kala for answers. She told Chandler that the kidnapper's leader's name is Sardo Numspa and that the dagger was created to kill the special child, which Sardo plans to to use for his evil deed. After leaving Kala, they discussed the situation and decided Chandler should go to Tibet to retrieve the dagger, though he was initially reluctant to travel there. Eventually, Miss Tibet persuaded him, and they flew to Tibet. In Tibet, Chandler and Miss Tibet split up in a crowded place. Chandler followed a familiar bird, which led him to an old man selling necklaces. Chandler bought one, but the old man overcharged him, taking a $100 note. When Chandler protested, the old man disappeared with his money. Later, Miss Tibet informed Chandler that she had arranged a meeting with someone who would give them the dagger. To Chandler's surprise, the temple leader they met was the old man who had taken his money. The old man insisted Chandler personally request the dagger, which he did angrily. The old man explained that only someone with a pure heart could retrieve the dagger. They were led to an underground location where the dagger was kept. Chandler, being the chosen one, was instructed to walk a path without spilling water from a glass he was given, emphasizing the need for purity. The path was challenging, involving stepping on tree branches, but Chandler managed without spilling the water. At the end of the path, Chandler found the dagger under a flame. As he reached for the dagger, the fire burned his hands. Remembering the old man's words about purity and the water, Chandler drank the water, which extinguished the fire immediately. Excitedly, Chandler then grabbed the dagger. Chandler stepped outside to speak with the old man, seeking advice on how to win over a woman he loved. The old man offered him some advice, and Chandler left. Afterwards, the old man approached Miss Tibet, and during their conversation, it was revealed that he was her father. He expressed his approval of Chandler, noting that she liked him and giving his blessing for her to be with Chandler because he saw him as a good man. Later, Chandler and Miss Tibet left Tibet. At the airport, the leader of the kidnappers confronted Chandler, demanding the dagger. Chandler refused to hand it over, unsure if the special boy would be safe if he gave the dagger to the leader. Annoyed, the leader left. Chandler and Miss Tibet then headed to a hotel, but were soon disrupted by men attacking the hotel guard. Hearing the noise, Chandler urged Miss Tibet that they needed to leave immediately. Outside, they were attacked, and during the altercation, Miss Tibet was shot by an arrow when she stepped in front of Chandler to protect him. The attackers then left. Chandler took the injured Miss Tibet to the mysterious lady, Kala, where a man informed him that Miss Tibet was not yet dead, but would be soon. Kala urged Chandler to save the boy, claiming that the boy had the power to revive Miss Tibet. In a fit of anger, Chandler pulled back Kala's veil, seeing her true form for the first time. After leaving Kala's place, Chandler followed the earlier seen bird to the house where the boy was hidden. He sneaked in, confronting and dispatching one of the guards, and was almost caught by another armed man. Fortunately, the man who had previously played with the boy came to Chandler's rescue, affected by the boy's earlier touch to help him. He led Chandler to the boy, and they managed to free him. Chandler attempted to confront the leader of the cult, who then transformed into a demon. Frightened, Chandler fled with the boy. As they drove away, the demon pursued and attacked their car. They crashed into a building which began to collapse, but they managed to escape and rushed to where Miss Tibet was kept. The demon followed and tried to seize the dagger, but the boy moved it to Chandler's hand, allowing him to use it against the demon. The movie ends with Chandler, the boy, and a recovering Miss Tibet walking away together, enjoying their time together. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give a thumbs up and subscribe. Take care, and see you next time.